So this is Tim from the Alberta Sign Association and from High Signs, and we want to ask him today in the sign industry, what is your basically main pet peeve? What is kind of the most frustrating part of your job?
Well, the most frustrating part of my job and our industry is its lack of notoriety. Every day people travel, and they travel by looking and reading and following signage. But we as an industry don't promote ourselves to the magnitude that we need to show the pride and craftsmanship that we have in our industry. So if I had one particular pet peeve, that would be it.
This is Peter from the airport, from GTAA, and he basically manages sign operations there. And we're here today to ask him about what's the most frustrating part of his job day to day.
Okay, where to begin? No, actually, for the most part, I find all the sign suppliers good to work with. We're in the midst of revamping some of the signs at the airport, and one of the frustrating things I'm finding is that we have a sign manufacturer for the extrusions that works with our contractors, and they're sort of bouncing off each other, where the extrusion guy says, no, this is your job, and the manufacturers are saying, no, you need to give us more, because why are we doing all this extra work? And so then I go to my manufacturer saying, what's going on? And they're saying, well, we're working with the extrusion guys, and they're giving us a hard time, and now they're giving us lead times that aren't reasonable, and yada, yada, yada. I mean, of course, we're developing a new extrusion, so that's complicating things as well. So that's one of the things I'm dealing with.
Is part of what makes things difficult at the airport that you are trying out so many products that are kind of for the first time or very innovative?
Yeah, we went through that with the Terminal 1 signage program. We had a custom system built for all the wayfinding signs, and we were working with a company that developed a 347 low voltage lighting system, which was not really tested in the market at the time, so we were kind of the guinea pigs for that, and it turned out to be a nightmare because there was a lot of failures. Typically they did 120 volt, but we had 347, so they did kind of custom designed this new product for us, and so we ultimately experienced a whole lot of failures.
And what's a problem you're trying to solve right now in your business?
I think the Sign Association has to unite as a professional body. I think that the vendors versus the service industry have not met yet. They're so busy with the convenience of being able to shop the services, no one will commit to building good business brands with services and suppliers. It's very important that we go forward and work together as companies for one goal: satisfy a customer for a long time, not one time.
So day to day for you, how does that challenge kind of manifest itself for you?
We see new companies always searching for supply install people. We see under-equipped companies jump into service arenas they're not able to do, and it ruins the market for most people. A customer wants to buy something painlessly, so we don't want people taking stabs in the dark or best guesses with their equipment and not being able to keep up to the service demands. So, on the larger organizations that just like to print film, we want them to send film to us, we rep them, we enjoy a great relationship doing the service end of it, and they enjoy a customer that's satisfied with the service quality and the production quality.
So this is Lance from Speedpro, and we're asking Lance today, he's here at CONSAC, and we're kind of wondering, when he comes to a show like this, does he have specific problems he's looking to solve or solutions that he's looking for in the industry?
There's a whole list. I got a whole list of new products I'm wanting to look at, and even looking at new suppliers and seeing who can work with the Speedpro chain, because we do have over 45 stores across Canada, so we're always looking for new suppliers and for new products that will make us more profitable.
What would you say is sort of like the most frustrating or pet peeve kind of thing in your daily business that you're looking to solve?
That's a good question. I don't really have an answer to that.
There's no particular sort of bugaboos where you're kind of like, oh, I need like a new product to do this or a new service to help with this?
Sometimes a customer comes in asking for something that really is off the beam, something that we really don't make as a sign company. But because they're a regular customer, we have to source that. So sometimes printing, which we don't, you know, a sign company does do a lot of in-house printing of brochures, so we'd like to find a good supplier of that. And sometimes it can be just something weird and off the cuff, but it's completely out of the industry. So that's probably the biggest time burner for me.
Do you ever get the feeling there's anything you kind of have to, business you have to turn away that you'd rather be able to handle in-house, like where you're up to say, no, you're going to have to go to this company for that?
No, we got a pretty good network of suppliers that will wholesale to us. So, and that's one thing we find at a trade show like this is we can make connections with those kind of people. So we rarely have to turn anybody away because of shows like this.
I'm here today with Finian at our booth at CONSAC from FP Creative Solutions. And I'm asking him today why, when he comes to CONSAC, what is he looking to learn? What kind of problems in his daily business is he looking to solve?
The reason why I come to the CONSAC show is because there's so many new ideas that I could use in my business to expand products to my customers, and because that's the reason why I'm called Creative Solutions, is that because I can come up with ideas for people to use me instead of using somebody else, so I come up with the idea.
Can you give some examples of what this year you'd be looking at that you haven't done before?
Laser printing, channel printing, and also CNC printing. I mostly work with type of horse people where they want signs on their trailers, or if there's a bump under a trailer, I'll try and figure out how to fix that bump that they have. So
that's a really interesting market. So you must have a unique perspective when day-to-day business. What would you say are the most kind of, you know, frustrating things to happen? Is there cases where there's sometimes work you can't handle, or what would you say are sort of the bumps along the road for you?
The real bump on the road is dealing with clients that nickel and dime you. But then, for them, you have to prove to them that you're worth what you are.
So the problem resolves itself usually.
Right, yes.
Okay, good to hear. And sorry, what did you want to say about Sign Media Canada and how it's been useful to you?
I've been a subscriber for probably about 6 or 7 years, I think, pretty well anyway. And I keep all the back issues because you never know what you're going to... What problems you might run up to, and then also they have problem-solving interviews with other companies. So, and then I work from there to be able to come up with solutions for my customers.
Okay, so when you think about some of the technologies you're talking about introducing, CNC and such, to your business, what are you looking to in terms of applications, new applications to create?
Products that nobody else offers in my surrounding area or in Ottawa or...
Yeah, so can you give examples of those?
The cottage signs, and also signs for lawyers and all this other stuff, because they want the bronze look and all this other stuff, so that's basically that's right.